Namaste. Hey guys, today we are back with another video to discuss in detail one of the most important structures where Nadi Pariksha is done. I'm sure most of you guys would have figured it out. Well, yes, we are referring to the radial artery. The radial artery is one of the major arteries that supply the forearm. Many of you might have a very obvious question. Why is the radial artery most commonly used for pulse examination all over the world? It is one of the most superficial arteries in the body. It has a straight linear axis for approximately 70 mm at the lower one-third subcutaneously. It runs above the flat surface of the radius bone, making it possible to press against a hard surface. Hemodynamically, there is a pressure variation in the aorta and radial artery. The systolic arterial pressure in the radial artery is 9.3 plus or minus 5.3 millimeters of mercury higher than in the aorta. This is due to the reduced lumen size, providing better access to the pulse reading. The radial artery is immovable as it is held between two fibrous structures, one at the superficial fascia and other at the wristband. Due to the close relation of the distal radial artery with the tendons of extensor pollicis longus, extensor pollicis brevis and abductor pollicis longus, when the wrist is extended, the radial artery is raised superficially. The above statements justify why the radial artery is the most commonly used site for pulse examination. Now let's quickly jump into the anatomy of the radial artery. The radial artery has its origin from the brachial artery. The brachial artery bifurcates in the anterior part of the cubital fossa to form two branches, that are the ulnar artery which runs medially and the radial artery which runs laterally. The course of the radial artery begins from the anterior part of the cubital fossa, runs distally on the anterior part of the forearm, where it lies on the hard surface of the radius, which facilitates pulsation as mentioned in the beginning. Proximally, it is covered by the brachioradialis, whereas distally, it is covered by just the fascia and the skin. This is the first part of the artery and it has the following branches. The radial recurrent artery, which arises in the cubital fossa, muscular branches to supply the various forearm muscles, the superficial palmar artery, which arises just above the wrist, completing the superficial palmar arch, and the palmar carpal artery, which arises at the distal border of the pronator quadratus muscle to form the palmar carpal arch. At the wrist, the radial artery goes around it laterally and reaches the proximal end of the first interosseous space. This is the second part. The following branches arise from this part. The dorsal carpal artery arises while the radial artery winds laterally across the wrist and it forms the dorsal carpal arch. The two dorsal digital arteries of the thumb and the dorsal digital artery to the radial side of the index finger also arise from this part. The radial artery then travels across the floor of the anatomical snuff box to the palm of the hand to complete the deep palmar arch. The princeps pollicis artery is given out where the main radial artery enters the palm and gives rise to two palmar digital arteries. The radialis indicis artery is given out immediately distal and runs along the radial border of the index finger. Let's now try to know its clinical significances. It is the most common site for pulse examination. As told while explaining the anatomy, the distal end of the artery runs against the hard surface of the bone. This aspect, along with it being covered by fascia and skin, together contributes to easy pulse reading. The radial artery is an ideal graft candidate for coronary artery bypass procedure due to its diameter, length, and ease of harvesting of the blood vessel. Blood sample is collected from the radial artery for a blood gas analysis or BGA test due to its easy access. Let us now review what we have learnt in this video. We tried to understand why globally The radial artery is considered the ideal site for pulse examination. We then looked into the anatomy of the radial artery. The radial artery originates from the brachial artery and runs from the cubital fossa to the palm and can be divided into three parts. We also looked into the branches of the radial artery. Finally, we looked into a few clinical significances of this artery. If you like this video, hit the like button and comment with your opinions. Consider subscribing to our channel and share with your friends. Follow us on Instagram and Facebook for more updates.